hello everyone. You're on board with me, Jason West, in the underscore racing BMW M3. And today we're at Brands Hatch. It's race two, it's Easter Sunday, and we're in the Kumho BMW Championship. The grid's a little depleted today, which is a real shame. Jazz and Brian are racing at Netherton in a two-hour endurance race, and they were third and fourth yesterday, so then, you know, the race yesterday, race one, was very much a two-horse race between James Card and Frontier and me. But as I said to James, you only need two cars to have a race. So, question I've been asked, and not unreasonably so, is how come there's so few Kumho cars on the grid? And there's for a few reasons. Firstly, it is Easter Sunday, and there's a lot of people away on holiday. Secondly, we've got a lot of cars that aren't yet ready. But also, there were some question marks about whether the championship would be going ahead this year. And I'm very pleased to say that thanks to the BARC, who've done an amazing job, we have secured the championship this year. So that will remove the uncertainty that was in the minds of a lot of competitors. And we should have much better grids from the next race at Snetterton, which I believe is the 13th of May. So not a massive grid today. I think we're only seven cars. So James and I will do our best to put on a decent race. Yesterday we had a massive oil slick here. I was on pole, James was in second, and there was just a vast sea of oil in front of me. So made a pretty good getaway, but then the oil got me and James got round the outside. And this is one difficult circuit to overtake on at the best of times. It's frantic, there's a lot of elevation change, there's a corner after corner, and I will concentrate just for a bit now. Red lights. Too much wheel spin. It's on my side. So first we got round the first corner, which is nice. Keep it nice, neat, tidy, keep it tight. Keep it off the curbs until the tyres come up to pressure. Lock that one. So we're turning in early here to shorten the corner. Fun of us. Always in two minds about whether it's worth doing that or not. But we'll seem to find out. We'll have a look at the lap time. So pressures are coming up. Should be able to start using the curb soon. Thank you. Yesterday's race, Fran did a bit of grass tracking and caused his car to overheat, which then dumped a whole load of fluid down into the corner we've just been through, which I would like to say took me by surprise, and I parked the car on the grass, or threw the car onto the grass. But that's not actually what happened. The fluid was down for ages. We all knew it was there. I was chasing James, and for some reason, only to me, no fairness, I don't think I know why, I just took it a bit too wide in the 30s, and threw the car at 107 miles an hour sideways, which then caused a bit of a problem, and we went a bit grass tracking. I'll just try and get into fourth and reverse, see what that's like. I'd rather not have a repeat of that today. Car's feeling better. Not quite so much understeer. It's got his eyes on. Oh. Good half a second off the pace there by shifting up the fork. Third and run the limiter. So we're still trying to learn how to drive this setup. So you'll be seeing me try a few things. Some of them might work, some of them categorically won't. Hopefully we keep it out of the barrier. Track limit. which means we have to be a lot neater and tidier. Very little room for error. Behind Kev, Kevin Hemworth, who doesn't have any power steering today, so hopefully he's getting on alright in there. It's actually quite warm all in all, and it's going to be much warmer in Kev's car.
Kev's car in fact dropped back on that last lap because Jason West did a 50.628, he's getting quicker, Jason West.
So just trying a little dab of brake into lefty righty bit, I think it's good 13. Just to see if that would help. That time? Nope, not really. Next session, we're going to see Niall Bradley. because Niall's a bit of a specialist around France. Had good races with him in the past, like last year. So it's going to be interesting if he makes it to Stetson. I really hope he does. We've also got Brad Sheehan, who's an engine that had all sorts of issues, having a new one built. Hopefully we're going to see Brad out in his rather fetching pink and white T46 M3. So come Brad, get it sorted mate. Racing was a classic scoring Thunder Saloon, and at that race was Paul Cook, who is a regular BMW car club driver. That was the first time I believe Paul was racing on the thing. Sadly the weather there kind of got a bit wet, and the bloody hard is a rather rubbishy Dunlop road tyres rather than full race wet that we were running up the front. So I'm not sure how much you really got to try this thing. So yeah, you gotta beat, you can't beat racing on a BMW M3 or full racing thing. I think we'll do one that. Now can we get the lap times out of these cars? Actually not, because they're running big power or anything like that. It's because the chassis are well sorted and these Kumho slicks are brilliant. They last really well, they are super fast, and they only cost, I think it's £940 a set, delivered with VAT, and I know that's a lot of money, but we get at least three race weekends out of them, and then we can still use them for testing afterwards, so they are a bit of a billy bargain, especially compared to the cost of other brand slicks. If you've got a track car, especially if it's an M3, check yourself at the Kumho slicks if you want to see just how fast the car can go. There you go, there's my advertising for Kumho. I wonder when this race is going to end. Not that I want it to. Here we go, fast. Quite hot though. Tires aren't low, they're holding well. Oh, 3 minutes 41. So I've got about another 3 laps roughly. That's what happens when take a bit more speed through there. Just set it off the throttle a little bit early just to see what would happen. That came round, which is good. And once the car has got a little bit of rotation, this has probably in fact got a bit too much now if I'm being honest, but it does make it a lot more fun to drive. Oh, helicopter up there. Is that Mr. Palmer? Right, don't go cutting Mr. Palmer's grass when he's up above in his lovely helicopter. It was a lonely race to be honest. Oh, is it James alright? Can't see. Oh no, I just saw him. Yeah, now I'm wandering around in the middle of the track. Should probably concentrate, shouldn't I? Well, it certainly gets the hard way done. Okay, two more laps. I do like it when they put timers on the start-finish straight. The only thing with this one, right before the braking zone, so you only get a moment to clock the numbers before you need to be spotting where you're meant to be applying the brake. It can be a little bit hair-raising. Trevor. Well, it's a big box, isn't it? Chris up ahead. Suddenly you had a panic moment there that I misshifted, which I have done before, and almost launched the engine. I might put the link to the video up here somewhere. It was a rather worrying day, but the engine held together despite revving out to, I think it was 9,300 RPM, which, is pretty good really, considering these things redlined 8,000 out of the factory and we run them up to 8.2. So, good strong engine there. So thanks to G4 for building a nice strong engine that could be over-revved massively by an idiot driver and still hold together. So, sorry folks, this is not the most entertaining race. But then, it is a win. There we go. Good, everyone. Thank you. Oh, so, as ever, massive thanks to the marshals who are coming out on Easter Sunday, rather than being at church with their Easter bonnets on. I hope you've all had lovely chocolates this morning. Oh, whatever takes your fancy. So, look out for us in about 2 weeks' time. We're back here at Brands Hatch on the Indy Circuit with classic touring cars Thunder Saloon. And if you want to see something interesting, have a look at these massive Aussie V8s as they're manhandled around this tight little circuit. It's a sight to behold. So yeah, do the usual YouTubey stuff, the liking and subscribing. My mission is to get to 1,000 subscribers in the hope that YouTube may one day pay me 50p. So if you like what you see, please do give us a hand and just press that subscribe button so I can get 50p and I'll be a happy bunny.
Well, with only 7 cars, bit of a procession at the front for Jason West in the end. We'll have a chat with him in a second. And James Carr. Tell you what, Jason West struggled to find the number one spot for about a few seconds. I had to do a 5-point turn to get in. But yeah, a lovely race. We'll have a chat right now. And I love to see this sort of camaraderie after all the races. We'll wait for Jason to get his helmet off. Got a bottle of champagne here and the number one cap. So one win apiece for James and Jason this weekend. Great way to start the championship for them. That's them done for the weekend. One apiece, good weekend.
Yeah, that was good, wasn't it?
Yeah,
not the most exciting to watch, I'm sure. James kept me honest to start with, but then I think had a misfire or something.
But very interestingly, you were lapping in 15 and a half seconds, right? The British touring cars do about 48 seconds. These are incredibly powerful machines.
Yeah, our good friend, Gary Whittaker, I'm sure once got his E36 M3 round here in something like 48.9. But then he is a legend, so.
He is, yeah. I mean, that's your weekend done. It's a first and a second place. Interestingly, you went from pole to second yesterday. Today you were second, had a great start. Why doesn't anybody want to win from pole in these cars?
I think we're going to have to ask our good colleagues in the trucks as to why they like to leave oil slicks off pole.
That's a really good point. How did you celebrate this weekend?
I'm going to have a sit down, I think.
And?
Yeah, why not? Let's have some rather fetching, I'm sure, English sparkling wine. Excellent.
Great weekend, well done.
Thank you very
Cheers,
much.
Buddy. We'll have a quick chat, James, as well. Just saying, a bit of a procession in the end there once he got away, but happy with your weekend's work?
Yeah, happy so far. That was unfortunate because we were having a good race, but it just started to develop a misfire at the corners. And it happened after about four or five laps, okay. And he was just eking away from it. And then at the end, it was getting worse and worse. So for the last kind of 9 minutes, I was just... I wanted to finish because we need as many cars finishing as we can.
And that was quite hot, I imagine.
To be honest, I wasn't pushing for half the race. So I was actually quite... I was all right in there because it wouldn't rev down the straight. So I was short shifting and everything. So, but it's the way it goes.
Great start to your championship defence.
Yeah, it's been a good weekend.
Well done. Cheers, thank buddy. You. Thank you.